Good evening, everyone here. I'm Dr. Sandeep from SV Multispecialty Hospital, Kodambakkam. I'm here to present a different topic in orthopedics, wherein you might have heard a treatment of a knee arthritis in terms of replacement, knee replacement and all. But I'm going to concentrate more about treatment without knee replacement, what are the possibilities and where we can do, where we cannot do. Well, I'm going to explain all those things. And as we know, arthritis is a progressive loss of cartilage, and it is mostly in aging changes. Broadly, it is classified into primary and secondary. Primary is idiopathic age-related changes which can occur in everybody. Secondary, it can occur mainly in terms of any joint pathologies, joint injuries, any metabolic bone disorders, etc. In those cases, the joint the architecture is lost, and thereby it will go for wear and tear very soon, sooner than the age it has to be. So in those cases, normally the age and the arthritic changes may not correlate so well in the secondary arthritis. So as we see here, these are the OA changes which can occur in any joint, which will be present. There will be a cyst here. The synovial membrane is hypertrophied. The hypertrophied synovial membrane will secrete more and more fluid, which will cause effusion. And there will be an excessive bone formation, where we call it as the osteophytes. And the cartilage and all is lost here. As you can see, the cartilage, the white one, is very good. This is normal knee. The cartilage is worn out here, and it is going to cause pain. This is an intraoperative picture of an arthritic knee just before taking the cuts in a knee replacement surgery. As you can see, this is a healthy cartilage which is present in the lateral compartment of the knee joint. The medial compartment is lost, its cartilage, and the underlying bone is exposed there. So that is a source of constant pain in knee arthritis, especially in the medial joint line arthritis. So previously, we used to have only this one. Previously, either you manage conservatively, what I'm talking is about 20 years back or something. Either you manage conservatively with only medicines, analgesics, NSAIDs and all, or you go for knee replacement. Now, knee replacement is the last option, very last option. We have got a variety of the things. Even myself, when we take a case scenario which is posted for knee replacement, I would just go through the patient. I'll just verify that whether all the other modalities have been done or not. So, the causes of pain in osteoarthritis, this is a very important slide with which I'm going to talk how we are going to tackle each one of them. Okay? And mainly there is an osseous hypertension because of the synovial hypertrophy and excessive effusion, the intra-articular pressure is increased and also an intra-osseous pressure. So this itself is a source of constant pain, and the protective cartilage is lost, synovial effect protection is lost, and as the age advances, the capsule, the ligaments and all get shrunk, and that will also be a cause of pain, and muscular weakness, which is quite common in old age groups. So the signs will be a varus deformity, cross varus. As you can see, there will be a confusion whether it is called a varus or a valgus. A simple way that I remember is, varus, vara vara in Tamil. So the knee joints will be away from each other. Val gum together. So the knee joint will be together. So normally, most common, there will be medial compartmental arthritis wherein the patient will have varus deformity. Very rarely we will have valgus deformity, depending on individual patient and their work, what they have done. And this is a condition where there is the focal loss of cartilage. This is a source of constant pain. That exposed bone will be rubbing when we walk. So that is a source of constant pain. And the investigations, I should mention a plain weight-bearing anteroposterior view and a lateral view is more than sufficient to assist a case of arthritis. No need of any MRI, no need of any other bigger modalities until unless we suspect any other pathology for the joint. So this will be a typical weight bearing picture. We can see an osteophyte here, extra bone growth. This white, dense white area is called the sclerosis. those are the earliest stages where we can see. And a plain X-ray, we grade the osteoarthritis in terms of this grading, where in grade 1, only 25%, grade 2, 50% reduction in the joint space, grade 3, up to 75% with or without osteophytes, and grade 4, complete loss of joint space. The treatment, we are going to go in this manner, in this measures. General measures, wherein we insist upon patient education first, what is it, what not to do, what to do, all those things has to be mentioned. And mainly, we should avoid squatting, sitting, cross legs. These are the two things which can increase the arthritis very rapidly. And the weight loss, when we minimal reduction of just 5 kilograms of weight, body weight, can produce about 18% gain in the overall function of the knee joint. So that much is important. So the more the weight loss will be, the lesser the burden on the knee joints. And the exercises, there are different modalities depending on each condition, whether we have any neuromuscular disorder, whether it is only an OA, whether there is any other joint pathology, depending on the different modalities. Mainly, we concentrate upon strengthening the quadriceps. That is the main muscle which can stabilize the knee joint very well. So these are the possible exercises, what we can suggest. And once started, it has to be continued lifelong. Then only the pain, everything, the effect will be. And bracing. When we have only a medial compartmental arthritis, a bracing can just realign the axis on which the patient bears weight. The weight-bearing axis is shifted to the lateral compartment here, as you can see. See, before putting the brace, after putting the brace. So there is an opening of the joint, thereby that medial compartmental, that pain will be controlled and the patient will feel better. And coming to physiotherapy, IFT, most common and most effective. And the other modalities also can be done, but it should be complemented with exercises and regular physical activities. Medical management, many drugs have been there. We can start with NSAIDs, even go for opioids, all those things. But nowadays, the joint supplements are gaining importance. Previously, we used to do glucosamine and chondroitin. Previously. But to produce that effect, we need to take about 6 months. 6 months continuously to have some, at least some significant improvement. Nowadays, we are using collagen peptides. Even more in that, now a product came called as undenatured collagen. That produces effect within a month. And these collagens are from non-vegetarian sources. But aflatoxin and curcumin is nothing but our household manchel, an extract from that. So these two are from vegetarian sources, which will be useful for patients who are not willing to take those capsules, collagens. And this is with respect to the non-interventional and conservative management. When we come to an interventional management, minimally invasive, I'm talking about all these five modalities. Corticosteroid injection, age-old procedure, produces very short-term effect, simple, very, very cheap, can be done as an outpatient procedure also. Not even going to the theater, but disadvantages is some people does not get any relief at all. And pain relief is very short, and sometimes in diabetics, they will have some systemic side effects also. It is prone to increase the sugar levels. Next is viscosupplementation, about 10 years old in Indian market. We have been giving viscosupplementation left and right, producing very, very good relief, but ideal patient conditions and patient selection is important. Not everyone can be given. In early arthritis, it is most effective, produces effect for more than 3-4 years, sometimes even 7-8 years also, they have produced a good relief of pain. It will mainly produce lubrication, which has been lost. I've told you in the initial slide, the loss protective loss of sensation, synovial fluid, we are going to restore with this viscosupplementation. And it is going to nourish the joint surfaces. So this is the procedure wherein we are going to disinfect the area by applying local COVID and iodine. Mark the area, I'm marking the lateral joint line above which we are going to inject. We'll give a local anesthetic first. and then give the viscose supplementation. It is as equal as giving a steroid injection, but we routinely don't recommend to be given it as an outpatient procedure. We recommend it to be given in an intraoperative, inside the operation theater. So after that injection, main advantage is they can return to their normal activities almost immediately, but no strenuous activities for about 2 days. About 10 to 15 days, they will require physiotherapy, they will require some analgesics, but after that, they will have good pain relief and there will be good regaining of function. Next, new thing in the market is platelet-rich plasma. We are going to extract blood from the patient and then centrifuge that and obtain the platelet-rich plasma and inject it to the joint. But it is not recommended routinely for arthritis. We give mainly for ligament injuries, ligament weaknesses, wherein it will heal the ligament faster and prevent secondary arthritis. That is what I want to mention here. Not for a primary OA, not for a simple age-related OA. It only helps in secondary arthritis. Nowadays, but PRP has got a lot of variety of applications, even dermatological and whatnot, hair transplants, so many things are there. And this is the procedure what we can do here. And very easy to administer, and most importantly, no side effects. Because we are going to use only the patient's blood. We are going to extract only the platelets and going to inject into the blood. Mainly for ligament injuries. And ozone therapy, I don't have much experience in this field, but more studies are required in India. It is, till now, whatever the studies, the short-term benefits are not very encouraging in Indian population, but in the Western population, this treatment has been very popular and very effective. In India, this is not very much regularly used. It mainly increases the body antioxidant system. That is how it works. And the best thing, or what I want to concentrate upon, is radio frequency ablation. This procedure is done as a very, very minimally invasive method, wherein we deliver some thermal current to the neural tissue and thereby blocks the pain signals from that particular neural tissue. Around the knee joint, we have about 5 geniculate branches which will produce pain. The medial retinacular, supramedial, supralateral, inferomedial and infrapatella. We routinely ablate the supramedial, supralateral and inferomedial, occasionally medial retinacular. But never we touch the infrapatella because the infrapatellar, the patellar tendon will lose its pain-bearing sensation by which there will be loss of balance. So this is the procedure where we give about long spinal needles are used. It is marked under image intensifier guidance and close proximity with the bone. And we are going to give about 80 degrees Celsius for 90 degrees each. 90 seconds each. So thereby that will ablate the neural tissue and the pain relief will be present for more than 2 years. It is going to adjust, block the pain signals and it will not alter the inside the pathology. So we are going to first initially confirm it under both the views, AP and lateral, and then do the procedure. This is a research paper published by me and my friend in Bangalore. Wherein we have studied about 60 patients. This is published very recently, about 6 months back. We have 60 patients here, which wherein we have done this RFA procedure, and progressively acetaminophen and diclofenac has been given. The follow-up is 2 weeks, 3 months, and 6 months. There is a good improvement in the pain. There is good improvement in the function, but two things where the study has been lacking is we did not give a pre-diagnostic block. The pre-diagnostic block is we just give about 1 ml of local anesthesia to the same sites, just wait for about half an hour, see the pain relief. If the patient has got good pain relief, then we will proceed with the RFA. Now, after the study, we have changed ourselves and the addition of this cold RF ablation probe. That is, previously we used to give a plain ablation probe wherein the heat energy is dispersed to the surrounding other soft tissues also. So the other soft tissues are unnecessarily exposed to this heat, and there we can avoid that by giving this cooled, the saline will irrigate there, and thereby only this probe is hot and not the whole body of the probe, only the tip is hot. This we have done in one patient coming from Andhra. Post knee replacement, there is the residual pain, and for even that patient also this can be used. It is a very simple procedure, can be done as an day care procedure, no admission, no invasive procedure, no anesthesia. We give only local anesthesia, direct the nerves, ablate the nerves and come back. That's all. The patient can be made to walk immediately. And recently we have started combining the procedure, producing very good synergistic effect. There is very, very good synergistic effect alternatively with exclusively each. This is the RF ablation. Post RF ablation, we give visco supplement. There is good relief. Individually, they produce about 2 to 3 years, but together combined can produce effect about 5 years also. Stem cell therapy, lot of research going on in this area. As you all know, stem cells are capable of growing into any tissue. So stem cells, only thing is it is little invasive. We are going to extract the stem cells from the ER bone and then going to centrifuge it and then inject into the joint. Coming to the surgical management, I'm not talking about knee replacement, but there are other surgeries where you can address many other issues. Arthroscopy, where we can just do a lavage, whereby the excessive metabolites are washed out. Synovectomy, especially in cases of rheumatoid arthritis and all, the burden of the disease will be reduced by just removing the excessive hypertrophic synovial membrane. And arthroscopic debridement of the joint, not routinely recommended except in conditions of these. See, there is focal loss of cartilage, as I have shown you a picture. This was a case just operated yesterday, I have done. And I have noticed a focal loss of cartilage. I have debrided that excessive cartilage. Otherwise, this will be flipping, and that itself is a cause of pain. And I have created micro fractures here. That is, we are going to punch inside, and there will be a bone marrow or tissue coming outside that can grow into the cartilage. Without doing anything, I was not prepared for this, but this is possible. Mosaicplasty, for the same conditions, if we have the picture preoperatively, we know that there is a focal loss of cartilage, we can take the cartilage plugs from a less important area, non-articular area, and then plug it in at the defect. As you can see here, I have taken the, this was done about 2 years back. This was the area which I have taken. It is an intercondylar area which does not actively participate in the articulation. And I have plugged it here where there was loss of cartilage. And chondrocyte implantation, wherein we culture the cartilage cells and then inject at that area. That is possible. I don't have personal experience in that. This now picking up, this surgical procedure. I was always speaking about medial compartmental OA, very common and all. When we want to see, this is the preoperative picture. There is a great medial compartmental arthritis by wherein this is the weight bearing long axis here, long axis of the lower limb, where you can see it is passing just at the center. Now we want to shift it to the lateral side, where there is a good amount of cartilage available. So this can be done in the same way. This is another patient wherein we create a wedge, open out the tibia, so that if we are going to realign the fracture here. We are going to create a fracture and then we are going to realign the mechanical axis. As you can see here, it has been medial, the weight bearing axis is on the medial side. Now we have shifted to the lateral side. This I have operated just 2 days back. I don't have the post-operative full length radiograph because we cannot mobilize the patient immediately. We need the fracture to heal. And unicompartmental arthritis, I don't have personal experience, very rarely used, mainly for medial compartmental arthritis. Very effective procedure theoretically, but practically not very much effective. More common in the Westerners, not in Indian population. And last but not the least, the knee replacement. Having said and done all these things, knee replacement is a very good option, permanent solution, patient one time addressing of the issue, no repeated procedures and all. And but where have been other modalities of fit? I have explained so many modalities, but I should say that sometimes it so happens the x-rays may not correlate with the clinical picture. We are going to treat the patient and not the x-ray. Sometimes the x-ray will show only grade 1 arthritis, but the patient will have very severe pain, very restriction of mobility. So in that case, we cannot start with a very simple procedure like just corticosteroid. They have to be subjected to a bigger procedure, whatever it may be, depending on the pain and the difficulty they are having. So the take-home points, treatment with all these things, only early stages possible, very late stages, we don't have anything to save, and we cannot avoid the knee replacement. All treatment should be complemented by lifestyle changes and weight reduction. Very important. And regular exercises. Combination procedures, as I have told, can improve a lot, can have synergistic effect with each of them. And with all these things, should not promise any complete cure, because we cannot cure the problem, we can just control it and try to prolong the natural joint. Ultimately, the patient satisfaction is our investment in everything, and if they are satisfied, they are going to come back, and then we are going to be very happy seeing their result. Thank you very much. Any questions? If it is just a radio frequency ablation, it will be around some 40,000 rupees. 40,000 per knee. And if we combine a viscous supplementation, probably another 10,000 extra.
A small word of caution, in the slide he projected opioids as a system of treatment for pain relief. That should be the last option.
Last option, yes. First, we are going to treat only with conventional NSAIDs. Some people may not get complete relief from that. Only one injection I tell them about 3 to 4 years. 3 to 4 years. If the pain reappears again, we are going to take a fresh x-ray at that point of time, see the condition, see the patient, we can repeat it n number of times. Steroid injection generally does not, because the possibility of crystallization of that salt. Even one injection I give today, even after 3 years, for example, if the patient goes for knee replacement, I can see the crystals intraoperatively. So that crystal by itself is a source of pain. It gets solidified and gets attached to any cartilage defects or anything, any irregularities. So that itself is a constant source of pain.
And in preparation, the person compared?
We have not compared those two, sir. We have compared mainly afalopin and collagen peptides. Both have having good, almost similar results. But only thing is, one is from the non-vegetarian source, another is from the vegetarian source. Glucosamine contracted only after 6 months of usage only has got produced good relief. This one by 1 month, 1 to 1.5 months maximum, there is good relief of pain and good improvement of function.
How long will it have?
That can be given in 3 months. 3 months is an ideal time, an optimum result. We are going to increase the psychological benefit, man. The pain is reduced, the many of the patients, due to the pain, they don't have physical activity, and thereby the weight increases, and it's a vicious cycle. We are going to break the cycle by reducing the pain first. For that, we require a walking patient with more range of movements, because we are not going to alter the underlying pathology there. By reducing the pain, they'll be able to feel better, they'll be able to walk, they can go for any physical activities, they can go for walking, any exercises can be done, the weight reduction can occur, and thereby indirectly that will control the knee pain.
Thank you. I request Dr. Sridhar, our past president, leading ophthalmologist, to hand over a certificate of appreciation to Dr. Sandeep.